Good evening. Lock it down now. That is the Queensland Premier's message to her New South Wales counterpart. Pressure growing for our neighbour to begin a statewide lockdown.
The virus creeping towards the border, triggering new restrictions and forcing Queenslanders to pay the price.
The Premier with a spring in her step.
All right, good morning, Queensland.
Because while COVID's akin to a coiled spring,
we will see more cases.
We've got it squashed for now. 7 new infections in the school's cluster from St Aidan's, Ironside and Brisbane Boys Grammar. Many testing positive towards the end of isolation on days 10, 11 and 12, meaning for their families, it's back to square one. Another 2 weeks at home.
There is no doubt in my mind they have saved lives by what they've done.
Fortress Queensland built on the sacrifice of Queenslanders. Construction sites at Byron Bay stalled, with Queensland builders now banned from them. No longer deemed essential workers and not allowed to cross the border.
I would imagine that there would be absolutely thousands of Gold Coast workers that this has affected.
Like Michelle Chandler, a principal in Byron, but she lives in Robina, barred from attending her own school indefinitely.
I'm hoping that once the restrictions lifted in New South Wales, it will be from Queensland's perspective as well.
The next plight for anyone who's flown back into Queensland from the ACT since Monday, if that's you, you're being ordered into 2 weeks home quarantine.
And as of 1 a.m. on Saturday, anyone who arrives will be required to go into hotel quarantine.
With the virus contained here, their attention draws south. Our Premier all but demanding, in public and in National Cabinet, the New South Wales goes harder with a statewide lockdown.
New South Wales needs to have a clear plan for containment. Now it's up near the border, near where we are. It's of real concern.
Adam Hegarty, Nine News.
Well, they've been locked up in the lounge room for the past fortnight, but today hundreds of Indooroopilly High School students couldn't wipe the smiles off their faces as classes resumed. And it seems for many, the return to the classroom couldn't have come soon enough.
Indooroopilly State High School students are all class. After a two-week COVID hiatus, the bell finally rang and it was back to school this morning. Just 2 weeks ago, a student tested positive to the Delta strain. It not only shut down the Western Suburbs High School, but eventually locked down the state's southeast. So the government set parents and students an assignment: get tested and quarantined for 2 weeks, and they received full marks.
You have helped to keep Queensland safe, so thank you.
137 cases have now been linked to the Indooroopilly cluster. As a result, over 15,000 people were forced into home quarantine. But at the stroke of midnight, freedom. 6,000 were set free. Never, would it seem, have kids been more excited to return to the classroom. 2 weeks isolated from their friends.
Dad would be working, Mum would be working, I would be working, and then we'd all just go insane at the same time.
Emotions running at an all-time high for Year 12 students. Tuesday night would have been their formal, and final exams are fast approaching.
So close to externals and mocks and that kind of thing, and so you're just like, oh my goodness!
And relief for parents too, many of whom were forced to play the role of teacher.
It's kind of like the first day when you see them off, except the feeling of sadness and anxiety is replaced by a feeling of elation.
2 weeks too long, dropping the other two now, so free day today.
Both Brisbane Girls and Brisbane Boys Grammar have now been closed for almost 14 days. Both schools caught up in the Indooroopilly cluster. But the good news is, come Monday, classes will resume as normal. And in some further good news, come midnight tonight, thousands will be freed from home quarantine, meaning they can enjoy the weekend. However, there are those that are still required to be behind closed doors, and police are warning those people that officers will be conducting random checks. Melissa.
It's an ongoing situation, isn't it, Peter? Thank you. The COVID crisis in New South Wales is showing no sign of easing, with another record day of positive cases. And there have been more deaths as the virus leaked into the ACT.
Canberra, the nation's capital, shrouded in fog under the heavy cloud of COVID, and hundreds ignored the early morning cold to be tested. The outbreak, the first in over 12 months, grew to six, including a 14-year-old student. Worryingly, there are 4,000 close or casual contacts.
What we need is people to stay at home, to not mix with other people.
At the end of week 7 of lockdown, New South Wales just gets worse. A record 390 new cases, 60 in the community, and another 2 deaths. One, an unvaccinated woman in her 40s, died at home, taking the death toll to 38.
Unfortunately, this trend will continue for at least the next few days.
And the virus continues to creep through the state. 25 cases in Dubbo and the Central West, though there are none closer to the Queensland border. And no move at this stage to impose a statewide lockdown as residents continue to ignore the orders.
Delta is an extremely dangerous weapon, and some people are allowing it to be used as a weapon because of their ignorance, their stupidity, and their desire just to thumb their nose at the health orders and the law generally and the community.
In Victoria, another 15 cases, 3 are unlinked. How or where they were infected is a mystery.
These cases that are mystery cases are a concern to us, but this strategy is working in that we are steadily driving down the number of cases and driving up the number of people, the percentage of cases, of those cases who are isolated.
Lane Kelcutt, Nine News.
We're being urged to support city businesses that are tonight on the brink of collapse. Traders struggling to bounce back after rolling lockdowns and amid tightened mask restrictions.
Peak hour on the Captain Cook Bridge before lockdown, during lockdown and this morning. Friday the 13th and the city is effectively a ghost town.
The Delta variant has changed things and the people are a little bit more nervous than they were last time around.
Dave Cush is co-founder and winemaker at City Winery. He says the lack of office workers in the CBD, largely due to mask restrictions, is crushing.
The uncertainty around the whole thing is what makes it really difficult for us to plan. As a business, it's tough. You know, our revenue just this week is 40% down on what it normally would be.
Experts say it's not sustainable. Small businesses need support now more than ever.
Sadly, if we're not there to spend money in the shops that we love, the cafes and the bars that we love today, they aren't necessarily going to be alive when we do decide to come back.
But there is some good news on the horizon. The Chief Health Officer indicating the mask mandate could ease Sunday week, provided there are no more outbreaks.
But as soon as I think there's a risk, I'll ask for masks. And when I think there isn't a risk, I'll say we don't need masks. But at the moment, we all need to wear masks.
Every day longer is another on Struggle Street.
This short-term uncertainty where they can just decide that they're going to lock it down and you know, understand the reasoning behind that. But from a business owner's point of view, it's hard enough. Hospitality is hard enough as it is, you know, and this sort of thing, it's just a real kick in the guts.
And tonight, a major development in terms of support for Queensland's small businesses, a joint funding package between the state and federal governments to increase the Queensland small business grants from a total $260 million to $600 million. The opposition's been calling for this tonight. There are grants available to non-employing sole traders of $1,000. And then for businesses who employ other people, there are grants available from $5,000 to $25,000, depending on the size of that business. Melissa, this will go some way to helping those who have been struggling. For anyone interested, there is more information tonight at business.qld.gov.au.
Rhys, thank you.